This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. The True Story Behind Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho. Stranger Than Fiction Series Book Number 1. Fergus Mason. Absolute Crime Press. Anaheim, California. Copyright 2020 by Golgotha Press, Inc. All rights reserved. No part of this publication may be reproduced, distributed, or transmitted in any form, or by any means, including photocopying, recording, or other electronic or mechanical methods, without the prior written permission of the publisher, except in the case of brief quotations embodied in critical reviews and certain other non-commercial uses permitted by copyright law. Limited liability, disclaimer of warranty. While best efforts have been used in preparing this book, the author and publishers make no representations or warranties of any kind and assume no liabilities of any kind with respect to accuracy or completeness of the content, and specifically the author nor publisher shall be held liable or responsible to any person or entity with respect to any loss or incidental or consequential damages caused or alleged to have been caused, directly or indirectly without limitations, by the information or programs contained herein. Furthermore, readers should be aware that the internet sites listed in this work may have changed or disappeared. This work is sold with the understanding that the advice inside may not be suitable in every situation. Trademarks. Where trademarks are used in this book, this infers no endorsement or any affiliation with this book. Any trademarks, including, but not limiting to, screenshots, used in this book are solely used for editorial and educational purposes. Contents. About Absolute Crime. Introduction. Genesis of a Monster. The Real Buffalo Bill. House of Horrors. Thinking About Norman. Challenging Hollywood. Creating the Plot. Shooting Begins. Creating the Horror. Reception. Conclusion. Ready for more? The True Story Behind Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds. Exposing Jack the Stripper, a biography of the worst serial killer you've probably never heard of. The Sapphire Affair, the true story behind Alfred Hitchcock's Topaz. The Perfect Crime, the real-life crime that inspired Hitchcock's Rope. The true story behind Alfred Hitchcock's The Wrong Man. Newsletter offer. About Absolute Crime. Absolute Crime publishes only the best true crime literature. Our focus is on the crimes that you've probably never heard of, but you are fascinated to read more about. With each engaging and gripping story, we try to let readers relive moments in history that some people have tried to forget. Remember, our books are not meant for the faint at heart. We don't hold back. If a crime is bloody, we let the words splatter across the page so you can experience the crime in the most horrifying way. If you enjoy this book, please visit our homepage, www.absolutecrime.com, to see other books we offer. If you have any feedback, we'd love to hear from you. Sign up for our mailing list and we'll send you out a free true crime book. http://www.absolutecrime.com/newsletter. Introduction. For movie buffs, Alfred Hitchcock will always be associated with a long list of Hollywood classics. Between 1921 and 1976, the English director known as the Master of Suspense released 52 feature films, many of which are still thrilling new audiences today. To most people, though, he's best known for a film that was very different, Psycho. As his nickname suggests, most of Hitchcock's movies are tightly plotted and intricate, using ingenious plot twists to keep viewers guessing until the last moment. Big budgets and glamorous scenery made his films as visually stunning as they were psychologically ingenious. Then, in 1959, he did something completely new. Intrigued by the low-budget horror titles that were being produced by small independents outside the Hollywood studio system, he decided to see how good one could be if a director of his talents was involved. His plot idea came from a newly published horror novel loosely inspired by one of the most gruesome crimes of the 1950s, the tale of a small-town grave robber and murderer who turned female bodies into grotesque homeware articles and freakish clothing. Hollywood wasn't interested in the book. Such sensationalist, not to say gory, material was beneath them, and the studio executives thought it wouldn't bring in the audiences. Hitchcock thought they were wrong, and with his trademark single-mindedness, he set out to prove it. Through the end of winter 1959 and into the early summer of 1960, Hitchcock worked in a small TV production lot outside the hub of Hollywood. As industry moguls shook their heads in reproach, he surrounded himself with his own production crew, taken from his TV show, and talked a small group of talented actors and actresses into risking their careers on a violent, morally ambiguous shocker. Tight security sealed his lot off from the curious press, until in late May he threw the doors open and invited the cameras in for a tantalizing trailer that he narrated himself. In the meantime, he had overcome technical challenges, budget problems, and the suspicion of the movie censors, who had battled with him over scenes showing fornication, murder, and, weirdly, bathroom fittings. By early June, the movie-going public was eager to learn what all the mystery was about. The film critics were less thrilled. Denied the advance screenings they felt their exalted status entitled them to, they sneered at Hitchcock's antics and predicted disaster for the movie. When the doors opened and they joined the public in front of the screen, their reviews were faintly damning. Not Hitchcock's best, the critics agreed. Unsubtle, a gimmick and in bad taste. The audiences didn't agree. They loved it, and flocked to see it in millions. By the end of the year, it was the highest-grossing film of Hitchcock's career, and the most profitable black-and-white movie of all time. Even today it remains popular. Three sequels and a TV spin-off have been made, and it even earned the dubious honor of a modern remake, which flopped. For Hollywood, Psycho changed the rules. The Prohibition-era censorship that set boundaries for the movie industry had been under strain for years and was being routinely bypassed by independents and foreign imports. Now one of the giants of the industry had driven a bulldozer straight through it. Within a few years, it had crumbled away completely and been replaced by the modern rating system. The success of Psycho opened the way for a flood of low-budget shockers, but it also left the road clear for classics of suspense horror like Halloween and Silence of the Lambs. Psycho hit the screen in June of 1960 and dominated theaters for the rest of the year. It was one of the first defining events of the 60s, challenging taboos about sex and violence that had never been seriously questioned before. It's remarkable that it all began years earlier in a tiny, conventional Wisconsin village. 1. Genesis of a Monster. For any director looking to make a suspense movie, serial killers are an obvious choice. Most homicides are one-offs, committed in the heat of the moment by a killer who makes little effort to cover their tracks afterwards. In fact, many of them, stricken with remorse, call the police right away to confess. You'd never guess it from Hollywood, but the words a homicide detective hears most often are probably, "I didn't mean to kill him." These squalid little everyday crimes don't have a lot of box office appeal, but serial killers are something else. Motivated and remorseless, using intricate planning or animal cunning to evade capture and stalk their next victim, the knowledge that they'll kill and kill again until stopped gives huge potential to build suspense. Fictional serial killers stalk many classic movies, including Dirty Harry, Halloween, The Hitcher, and the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise. Real-life killers have also been immortalized on film. The Son of Sam, Henry Lucas, The Zodiac Killer, and many more have inspired directors and horrified audiences. The murderer who's had the biggest influence on Hollywood, though, may not even have been a serial killer. He was convicted of a single murder and confessed to a second, although some people believe he may have committed at least another six, and there's plenty of circumstantial evidence to back that up. Even one murder is an appalling crime, but compared with the toll of John Wayne Gacy, at least 34 victims, Ted Bundy, at least 36, or Green River Killer Gary Ridgway, more than 90, he was strictly small-time. Despite that, the grotesque nature of his crimes inspired some of the best-known villains in cinema, including Leatherface in the Texas Chainsaw Massacre series, Buffalo Bill in The Silence of the Lambs, and the most famous movie murderer of them all, crazed motel owner Norman Bates. If somebody wanted to illustrate the melting pot idea of American immigration, they'd be hard-pressed to find a better example than Wisconsin. At one time or another, just about every wave of immigration to the USA has washed over the state. The one that's had most influence on it crested in the late 19th century, when hundreds of...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.